you believe what you believe. I'm just being a nerd who had to tell it, see. I'll be clean enough to this video. Welcome to the world of crazy. Crazy might be the feeling that you might get sometimes if you go advanced reality control route, which may or may not be an issue if you have experienced spiritual awakening or ascension or something like this. Or maybe you are a strong individual who has opinions that don't match the standard thinking, so you might know the feeling already. For me, it's normal. Let's talk about advanced reality control. Especially if you're from spiritual community, you know about common challenges like feeling lost, losing people, having surroundings change around. But that is a fluff. You'll pass, it will be fine. AlgoriSWo, specifically, when you clear your mind, you will for sure go through this. It's very fast rewiring of your consciousness. Instead of going the normal, standard, orthodox way of waiting, getting used to it, letting your brain slowly, it takes time, right? It's plastic. Slowly change to accommodate your new way of seeing the world. You can go that way, but what I'm talking about is a bit different. It's the same in general, it's all about the same, but it happens much faster because you use specific techniques that help you rewire your what you normally would accomplish over time on the spot. The challenge will be that because it happens very fast, it's possible that it can be messy. You know, I compare it with Jenga. You have all of this and you start your life with your reality is kind of like Jenga. So you start tinkering this a bit things. The more you do, the more it starts moving.
Spot.
And at some point it will be moving like this. The trick is that you don't just remove the thing, you need to redesign it. You need to find the third, the alternative, something that will benefit you and everyone else around, right? As your continuity. By now, you know that everyone around is you. However you apply it, with AlgoriSWo, it's a mirror. Everyone is the mirror. So if you see that someone, you or anyone else, is hurt, that means that you are hurting yourself. And as lack of self-love, you might see situations that are not kind. It looks kind of like with children. I want to be happy, says your soul. Like a child, you know, I want to be happy. Break the castle. So that's very much like it. When messy something happens around you, especially if you experience it now, like if you or someone else around you is sick or dying, or when you lose job or coronavirus happens or something like this, it's exactly like that. But I want to be happy. And you can sit and watch and adapt the way objective reality works. Or you can say, I am the cause, this is happening because I need to see something. We have many skills over time accumulated through generations of our species. We have this many, many, many scales, punishment, reward, good, bad, me, others. So you have all of this. And when we talk about rewiring your brain using this technology, it's all of these scales and you begin to remove one by one. Oh, here is the punishment, here is something else, I don't know, betrayal. And because it's so many of them in our standard psyche, I guess it's called in psychology. It's so many of it, so that every time you remove, something else appears. So really, it's kind of like shedding it off. It's not that you balance it in the traditional understanding, but it's reaching the point that it just dissolves, it disappears. Why talent digging? Because you dig through these things, and then at some point you see the something, the real core desire most of the time of something, and you see it in all its purity, and that's while you are getting there to that point, all of this happens. The good part is that it all passes, because at some point you will have majority of these things gone away, and it will be less painful emotionally, even though pain, as long as you keep digging, because you kind of remove this top layer and then your deeper works begin. But the quality is already different. You most likely will not be in really bad situations. If they happen, you will not be devastated by them, because you will already know that it happens for you, for your good. It just happens like this, you know? Because you want something so bad that, like this, it materializes like this.
Sid takes from the top and it falls.
No, I won.
That works. Katie has won.
Now the second challenge is going to be more unpleasant. But the difference with the first, with cleanups, is that cleanups stop being messy. They kind of stop being cleanups. You balance out better, you integrate with everything, you see the world differently, and by then you will already have this sturdy I am the causer. You will not fall out. We're talking subjectivity approach, AlgoriSWo. We. I. With the second one, is the difference. It will remain with you always, so it's a matter of getting used to it. You already know about honesty, being honest with yourself. This is very literal. I call this challenge face the ugly. Because it's subjective approach, you know that you create reality literally, that everyone around you is you. You know that if you have a fear, as example, it will not just go away. It will be standing there, knocking on your door. Hey, look at me, hey! So you have to look at that. With the ugly things, ugly behavior, wherever you see it that doesn't satisfy you, it's you. It's somewhere in your consciousness. You have some kind of data, and you have to find it. If you see this poop somewhere, you can look at it. Whew, it smells so bad. Wow. You can look at that and hope, normally with objective approach, that someone else will clean it. But with subjective, you know that it will be staying there. Even more, you will be walking further in your life, and it will keep coming. It can be compared to going to hell of your soul, basement. Talking about darkness and all of this, Judgment Day, it's all about the same day. Except judgment is not check mark which box it belongs to, right? But look at it and asking questions why it exists to begin with, you reach the point when it's, as I said, dissolved. I really like this book, Dorian Gray Portrait, however it's called. This is kind of like that. You have to not just look into this portrait of yours, you have to repaint it. Because when we're talking about unconditional love, full acceptance, forgiveness, all of this, unity, it means not loving it or accepting it in duality, but having it completely gone, this thing, and however it is. So you have to look into what really bothers you emotionally or physically and find good in it, see? And this is why it's so hard for some people, because normally with objective approach, we tend to blame still, maybe not the word blame here, but we still say, oh, it's someone, But like this, you have to, wherever you see around, you look at it and you say, yes, this is me. Yes, that's also me. It takes effort. When you have your mother dying, or when you have even virus around and so many people die, you have to look at that and say, yes, for some reason, I am benefiting from the fact that something like this is happening. It's horrifying. Sometimes you stop already being embarrassed at that point, but you will be surprised that, really, I have that in my mind? How is it even possible? It's hard, but it's so rewarding. If you go this fast track versus the safer, more familiar track of objectivity, meditations, manifestations, etc. If you go faster way, it's going to be challenging at first and empowering, because you not just look at it and then try force yourself or wait until your brain rewires to accept newfound truth. You fix it right away, and then the rest is just matter of waiting it out, basically. I mean, keeping working, keeping digging, I use that often, in order to remove a lot of other things that you haven't looked yet, so that it all is not conflicting with each other. The more you do that, the faster your cleanups disappear, stop being messy. And but you will still continue looking at the ugly, because it's there. Because we are humans, we have darkness as well. It's just a matter, do you want to look into that with the light? And that's the question that only you can answer. So, adios.